Brad Ruekberg.
Yeah. Wow. It was just some drama. Yeah, I'm Brad Ruekberg, and there is a lot of confusion because, you know, I'm not on the poster. See, I was told that I was too sexy for the poster, but that's bullshit. Look, Hogan's the sexiest guy here. Come on, let's give it up for Hogan one more time. Yeah, that was awesome. That's awesome. Yeah, I don't buy the sexy stuff. I mean, because, like, I was always told my whole life that I looked like the guy, the kid on the Mad Magazine cover, you know? Except slightly older and more gay, you know? That's not nice. Later on in life, I was told I looked like Tim Allen, but it was like, if Tim Allen had to go through 5 years of rehab instead of only three, I mean, that hurts. I don't really like that. So yeah, lovely day today. I spent most of it at the dog park with my dog. Any dog lovers out here? I saw some dog lovers coming in here. Yeah, the thing is, I have to be like a complete helicopter parent with my dog. I mean, worse than I ever had to with my daughter. I mean, the whole time at the dog park, I'm like, hey, Bo, stop humping, buddy. Wait a minute, I hope that's not a kid. He's supposed to know better than that. You know, and I'm like, hey, get off, get off. And, you know, the dog's just looking at me like, what do you think I'm trying to do? And, you know, people, they get kind of pissed off when their dog's being humped in front of their whole family. But I had this dad, a young dad with his young son, who, like, exploded at me. I'm going to have to clean up his language a little bit. He was like, your dog is butt-effing my dog right in front of my son. How am I supposed to explain this to my son? And I'm like, you know, I look over the kid. He's not upset. In fact, he's recording it with his iPhone. Yeah, but I have to take it real seriously. I'm like, Bo, I am so surprised at you. That is not like you at all. Now get off. Sorry, poor choice of words. Bo, come. Never mind, we're leaving. You know, most people get it. You know, the dog is fixed. This is how they play. This is not a sexual thing. It's a play thing. It's a dominance thing. Come on, since when did play and dominance have anything to do with sex, right? I mean, come on. Okay, I'm not going to use that line anymore. The other thing the dog does is super annoying. He always has to go the farthest end of the dog park to do his business. So, you know, by the time I get a bag and journey over there, I don't know if you guys play golf, but it's kind of like looking for a lost golf ball in the woods. It really is. I was like, where is it? I had it lined up with this tree. That's not it. That's old. That could be it. I don't see any plastic or glass in it, though. You know, you can't go back empty-handed, though, so, you know, I'm just going to have to play this one. I'm sorry, this is your dog's? Oh, you'd like for me to put it back? Okay. Hey, tell you what, just give me a penalty stroke and I'll drop a new one. How about that? This is kind of embarrassing. I was at the Ranger game, they were playing the national anthem, and I don't know if anybody else does this besides me. I had my hand over my heart. Does anybody do this? You have your hand over your heart and you start feeling if your nipple is erect? Does anybody do that? Just me? Oh, great. Okay, a few people. Yeah, I wasn't the only one. I looked around. I saw some women doing that, or they might have been checking for lumps or cysts. Now, I asked them if I could check the lumps or cysts. They didn't like that at all. It's nice my daughter came home from college, and I felt it was time that we had to talk about responsible drinking. I was like, Isabella, if you open up a beer, finish it. Don't waste it. Just drink responsibly. Come on. So computer dating is weird. My friends love it, particularly the married ones for some reason. I don't know what's up with that. But yeah, I got catfished a while back. I didn't like that at all. Yeah, I mean, this woman, she had like young, beautiful pictures. I met her in person and she looked, she looked like a catfish. She did. She was like, you know, gray, whiskers, gills, you know. And this never happens to me. It's usually the opposite. I meet most women, they look a lot better in person than their crappy profile pictures. They really do. And, you know, I'll even tell them, I'm like, hey, I'm kind of like a professional photographer. Let me help you out, you know? Here, let's step away from the bathroom mirror and the toilet you just used. And, thank you. And, you know, we'll take you a good profile pic. Maybe you'll get a better date than me, okay? You know? You know, I'm really kind of at the point I decided, I was like not even going to try to meet women online anymore. I was just kind of like going to meet them, like, I don't know, like somewhere on Earth. Is that doable? But yeah, I realized I was going to have to really raise my game with the pickup lines. I'm so bad at them. I was trying this one, I don't know. I was like, hey, can I have your phone number? No, not your phone number, your social security number, because I'm going to need to 1099 that ass when I'm done working it. And yeah, that one never works. Doesn't work well. Anyway, I think that's my time. We're going to get Ross Day up here. I remembered his name. Thank you so much.